All right, guys, we're going to be starting up about 2 to 3 minutes. 2 to 3 minutes, we're going to start up. All right. Two more minutes. Two more minutes. It's going to take off. Two more minutes. One more minute, 7 o'clock, 7:01, we're gonna start. All right, guys, it's 7:01. I'm going to start up. Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
All right, let's roll. Yes. Basically, this week, this is the first time I've done this in a long time. We have, you know, several people ask me about doing a weekly recap or outlook. I mean, not outlook, because I do that on Sundays. And I've been doing some trainings, and I noticed that. And this is just to help you guys that, you know, a lot of guys are not having success because you don't have a plan. You're not really, you're trading just to be trading. All you're doing is looking at your account, if that makes sense. Because just like right now, the market's closed. The reason, and I wanted to make sure I do this when the market's closed besides crypto. But at the end of the week, guys, but if either you do it today or over the weekend before the market opens on Sunday, you need to review all your trades. You need to go back and look at, okay, all right, how many trades did I take? What was my average stop loss? What was my average take profit? What was my daily goal in those? How many pips did I get? You know, how many wins, how many losses? It's amazing when I'm talking to people and they don't know that. So it's like, how do you know if you're progressing? Or how do you know if your skill is progressing, because you're just trading. All you're looking at is the bottom line with the account. And trust me, if you're just looking at the bottom line, the account, it's not going to work. So tonight, this is basically what I do. I do this every week on my own. Sometimes I do it on Friday. Sometimes I just do it Saturday, especially if I had a bad week. Now, not too many times if I'm having a great week, which really I'm having a great year. But definitely if I'm having a bad week, I need to go back and make sure that, you know, what was I doing everything correctly? Was I missing something? Was I rushing? I need to figure out, because everything that we do is about making money, right? And if you're not making money, and that's another thing, you know, I ask the question a lot, you know, people, we come to make money, right? But we ask the question, who's making money? Nobody say anything. And then, you know, it's like, okay, we're here, you know, we got this free chat, we got the other group going on. We have everything, information, if you just want to get some free nuggets, we have everything you need, you know, to meet you halfway to make money. With that said, and this is also open, you know, round table discussion. I want to know what kind of, if you guys have any questions about your own trading, something that you want me to break down, something you don't understand. This is really for you guys. Anybody. Well, we're gonna start out. The floor is open. Anybody have any questions before I get into just looking at some potential trades that we took over the week?
Eric, yes. This is Vince.
Hey, what's up, Vince?
How's it going?
Great.
you know, I see the progression as far as, you know, the one-on-ones in regards to the charts and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
My issue that I still need to try to figure out, and we've had this conversation, is really just getting organized in regards to, you know, marking up the chart and then, you know, taking the trade. And then when I, you know, win or lose, you know, keeping a, you know, keeping a journal, I guess I still need to try to, I'm still trying to figure out the best way to do that, if I'm making sense.
Yeah, I mean, you know, basically you, to me, and I'm just, you know, I don't know your schedule, basically you, and I think I talked, you talked with, you know, you work, you got a full-time job and stuff like that. But basically yeah, what yeah. you need to do to be organized, you need to, if you're busy, and I tell people all the time, if you got a full-time job, you're working, don't worry about trading. You need to, out of the 5 days, just say from Sunday to Friday, you know, to Thursday, basically. Out of, you know, if your time is only at night at 8 or 9, then you need to set aside that time to focus on what you're doing and write everything down. I think, you know, this may be you, may not be, but it sounds like me, that's the problem. You're not really committing to the time and focus on it. You're more like putting your toe in at 7 o'clock, then you're dipping your heel in at 9 o'clock, and then you're on your way to work, you're rushing out the door, blah, 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 blah. Right or wrong? Pretty much?
No. Actually, I put the time in, but what I'm saying is, as far as, like you were telling me, that I need to journal everything, or like if I just think I need to figure out a way to do a journal. I guess.
All right. Well, that's different from me, because it sounded like to me, I was thinking that you were having issues with time or something like that. But this is how you, all right, let's go over that. Journal. Every time you take, go ahead. Question.
Because basically what I was trying to do, and I don't know if this worked, what I took the pairs, mm-hmm. I took all the pairs, and I created, because you know how you told me you can go into one pair and then go into another provider with the same pair?
Yeah.
So what I've done is I just went and saved a pair for two providers. So basically when I bring up my saved pairs,
mm-hmm.
they're two of each.
Okay.
And I'm trying to figure out if that would work better as far as.
I'm kind of confused on, all right, why do you have two? That's where I'm kind of getting confused. When, why do you have two?
Because I know, I guess because remember when you were saying that, you know, you mark something up and then you take the trade. Okay. I want to save that to go back to that. But let's just say I need to go back to that same pair. I want to go back to a blank pair. I don't want to go back to a pair that I already marked up.
If you're trying to see if you did the exact same thing, if you had an issue with it, this is the part. This would sound like to me. If I got a just like right now, the first chart when I get in these pairs, this is the only reason I have two sets. Euro Swiss franc was the first trade of the week right here, right? But if I want to break this down to show you why I got in this trade, I go to a blank pair, a clean slate. That's the only reason you should be going to another provider if you're trying to see what you did on the one you marked up was correct. But if it was already, if it hit take profit, you don't need another slate. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So that's why I'm kind of trying to understand why you having two. The only reason you should be going, just like right now, the only reason I'm going to go to Euro Swiss franc, another provider right here, which I did twice, or I had two trades on this, so forgot about that. But if I go to another provider, Euro Swiss franc, because I want it to be clean so I can break down, show you guys why did I take that buy. So basically, when you mark up your chart, say you marked up AUD USD for a sale, you got to mark up. If you go back to that and it went in your direction, you don't need to go to another clean slate. The only reason I will say go back, go to a clean provider is I lost that. Let me go break it down one more time, the trade plan, and see if I missed something. Okay. If that makes sense.
Okay.
Is that making sense, or is that what you was doing? I'm trying to understand. Yeah,
that's making sense. Yeah, yes.
All right. So that's the only thing you need to do. But in the meantime, every trade, I don't know about this. Do you guys hear that?
Yes, I hear it. I don't know who that is.
Sorry about that. That was a plane that flew over me.
No, now I hear that it's like the broker, you know, how it goes in and out.
Oh, no, that's not me.
Yeah,
that was me. I'm trying to. I didn't know I was me. I'm trying to figure out why it's doing it. Still doing it. It's carbon. Okay. Carbon capital.
All right, but let's get back. Hold up. Let's see if this can start. Is that you gonna have to mute? Is that you sure? That might be.
But I was muted. Somebody else is doing it too, though. I muted myself. Somebody else got their carbon capital going off too. It's
all right. All right, got it. All right, we're good. But getting back to Vince, what I'm trying to say, I want you to really focus on what you're having when you're saying you need to better understand how to journal. Is this make you know? So how like this week? What did you do for his journal when you took a trade or you marked up a trade? The only thing you should be doing is writing it down. It's like euros. If you took AUD USD on Monday. I charted up AUD USD. You got to chart it up. You should write it down in a notebook and said, okay, this is a sale. I had a 30 pip stop loss. I went for certain pips, blah, blah, blah. That's one. Then you go to trading view. Did I win that trade? Yep. That's it.
Okay. I guess I'm over. Yeah, I guess I'm over.
Go ahead.
No, I guess I'm just overcomplicating it, Eric.
All right, what were you doing? I mean, you know. I'm trying to. That's why I'm like, what's the? You had me confused. Like,
no, being all over the place. You know, like this is all still brand new to me.
Okay. I got you. But for anybody that's up here, that's really what it's all. It's just like right now. Like I said, I'm getting ready to go through. We had eight trades. All eight trades is up here. The only read, and I have them all already handwritten down in the notebook. That's it. What my take profit, what my stop loss, everything. And all I'm going to do is go through. I won, good trade, no problem. Really, I haven't had to do a lot of review because I've been winning everything. But if I definitely lose, I mean, I'm not trying to be funny, but if I'm definitely losing the trade, I want to go back and look at it and be okay and get back to you, Vince. The only thing you should go to the clean chart is when you lose a trade and go back and say, okay, this was an uptrend. Did I have my confluence? Did I have my rejections? Did everything was right per the trade plan? Yep, it just went against me, fine.
Okay.
Or you go back and review it on a clean slate and be like, oh, you know what? I didn't have my rejections. My trend line was off. I shouldn't have got in that trade. That's
so
it.
So what you're saying, the only reason I should be going to another clean slate as if there was an issue if I lost
yeah,
the trade.
If you want to check to make sure, because again, the only reason you want to clean because when you got the stuff up there, it's hard to, you know what I mean? It's in your way.
The backtrack, okay.
Like right now, the only reason that I'm looking at this is to show you guys, when I review this, is to show you guys why I took the buy. But if I'm sitting here looking at a journal just personally, why should I even look at that? I won. Keep it moving.
Okay.
You know what
that
I mean?
Makes sense. Yeah, that makes sense.
Now, let me flip it. You may want to do it just to make sure to keep, you know, just repetition is always good. So you may just go back and replay it on a clean slate just to do it over again, over and over. So that might be good for you. You know what I mean? Okay. Makes sense?
Makes sense.
But yeah, your journal. Anything, guys, anything that I do, events, you know, everything is basic, man. I'm not that smart. I never forget, I was training the guy. He had his Excel sheet, all this stuff, all that. That's too much. That's too much. I'm not doing all that. I'm not going to buy a journal. You know, some people buy journals online, Forex, and write all this stuff in. Man, I was just telling Kurt today, I got a $1.99 notebooks, and I keep maybe 10, and I run through them. Like right now, I turn around right now in my office, I have about 10 I done went through in the last 5 months. I handwrite, write everything down, and I keep it in front of me. That's it. And besides, with TradingView marked up, I keep it very simple.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that makes sense there.
Thank you. No problem. Good question, because you'll be amazed how many people don't think, you know, you got to ask questions like that to figure it out. You know, so I appreciate the question, and hopefully it'll simplify your journey, your journal, all that, you know. So, and like right now, you should be able to, okay, it's Friday. You should be able, I'm not going to put you on the spot. You should be able to go look back and be like, okay, I marked up 10 trades. First of all, do you know your numbers yet? you don't have to do it, but do you know your numbers? Don't worry about it.
No, like I said, I'm getting on board, Ari.
So I'm not peeking on you, so don't take it that wrong. Take it wrong.
Eric. Go ahead and pick on me, man. Keep me motivated.
I'm not picking up. But this is basic. This is why we're doing it. Because, guys, I'm being straight up. If you're trying to make money in this market, when the market's closed, you should be able to be like, if I call you up, if I call you up, unless you're at work and you haven't had time to come home and break it down, if I call you, we'll just say not Friday, because Friday gives everybody a chance to get settled. But if I call you Saturday evening, and I say, Vince, how many trades you take this week? How many wins? How many losses? What would you ask for stop loss? What would you take profit? What was your daily goal? You should be a bam, 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 bam. And anybody up here can't do that at the end of every week, think about it. I guarantee you're not successful. I guarantee it. It's like anything, guys. The more I think about it, we'll go to a job and we're gonna follow policies and procedures and do everything they tell us to do. So why, when it comes to Forex, where we can make thousands of dollars a day or a week or a month, we just kind of let it ride? Make sense? This is not a hobby. This is life-changing. And a lot of you guys have to treat it as life-changing. If this is a hobby for you, then you're dealing with the wrong person. Real talk. You don't need to deal with me. This is about making money with me. If you want to do this for fun, delete yourself, remove yourself from the group, and go to another group. This is not fun for me. We're going to have a good time when we withdraw the money, especially now with COVID over. I got a lot of friends up in Charlotte that I've taught that I help trade. We're going to meet up, and we're going to have some dinner and drinks, and we're going to enjoy ourselves. That's what it's all about. And talk about all the things that we're going to buy and help our family with. But if you're here just for fun, then I'm not the person you need to be dealing with. I'm going to just be as honest as I can be. Because I don't play. This is about making money. We'll have a good time. But, I mean, I hope you guys feel it. But good question, Vince. And I give it up to Vince. Vince been going hard, guys. Vince, we done did some one-on-ones. His charts is going, you know, up. I think Rudy's up. I don't know if he's up here. We're having a lot of things going on, man. We had Patrick, just one of my first students to just pass the FTMO, 200,000 funded account. He's just waiting for his days to pass so he can get a certificate. But they gave him 10 days to pass the second phase. He passed it in 2 days. And I'm going to just go ahead and say it. He passed it with my signals. That's all I'm going to say. You know,
good job, Patrick.
Go ahead. Yeah, I don't know if he's up here, but we have a lot of good things going on, guys. So I hope you guys can see the excitement. But we just want to help you guys, man. We want to help people make money and get involved. And I know you guys, just like when I started, man, I was like, got tired of people, you know, having a screenshot of profits and all this, and I'm over here blowing accounts and stuff like that. I'm a very competitive person. And I'm like this, if they can do it, I can do it. And same thing, I tell you guys, I'm no different from anybody. A lot of you guys on this call right now are probably a lot smarter than me. I just had the motivation to win. And the only difference between you and I right now is time. Trust me, Vince, I told you that in the training. You put the more time, and you've seen it, right, Vince? The more time you put on these charts, the more your charts are looking good.
Oh, yeah. I can identify stuff now. You look, you had to whip me into shape today, though, on the one you called me out on it. Mm-hmm. But no.
I got called out too.
Yeah. And what's this thing? Somebody said, what about using the likes of F? What about that? What is FX Blue? What is that? Oh, you talking about for journal and stuff like that? I tried. You know what? I forgot. I used what is it? FX Book. Is it FX Book? I tried it.
My FX Book.
I'm gonna just be straight up. I'm old school. I'm just one of those that I like. What I like, don't tell nobody, but I was still one of those guys that instead of using the GPS on the phone, I write my directions down on a piece of paper. Too long ago, I'm not gonna lie. Now I feel comfortable having my GPS on and let it, you know, run. And I'm just old school. So I tried that when I first, you know, started, and it was just trying to log in here, log in over there. You know, it's good. I know a lot of people use it, but for me, I'm old school. I don't need to, you know what? I don't need FX Book. Some of you guys that can maybe use FX Book and all that, that's what you want. I know people that have used Excel sheets and all that. I know what works for me works. So, but that's a good recommendation for the people that's what I want to say that has that level of skill when it comes
to tech savvy people.
Yeah, tech savvy people. I'm not tech savvy. I'm 4X savvy, but I ain't tech savvy. but yeah, good idea. But any other questions? But good way to start it off, Vince. Anybody else have any questions, issues with their trading this week? Something that you don't understand, you want me to break down, go over?
Because somebody just asked me directly here. I don't know what they mean. What other opportunities are we expecting from an easier way to trade? I mean, what do you mean?
What do you mean, other opportunities?
Yeah, what do you mean by other opportunities? I mean, we're doing what we're doing. What do you mean? Unmute yourself. I'm not sure what you mean. Said that to me personally. You can unmute yourself.
The only opportunity we got is
copy trading. Well, I mean, unmute yourself and ask your questions. We open here.
What's that?
He said like copy trading. We working now, on
it. I mean, I'm going to be straight up with you. That's stuff that Kirk can go over. We have opportunities like that coming up, but I'm gonna be honest with you guys. A lot of you guys get caught up on that stuff and you need to be learning to trade at the same time.
Right.
Let's quit being lazy and put the time in and learn the skill set. I'm tired. I'm just being straight up. Y'all can get off the call or whatever. I'm so tired of people, you know, we complain about what we don't have, what people ain't paying us, the jobs ain't, you know, being loyal to us, but we have an opportunity to learn a skill that can change our lives, but every time I turn around, I don't have time. I don't have time. I don't have time. If I show you my withdrawal yesterday, you will pass out. But we are so lazy. We are lazy people. I'm gonna just keep it real. But every time we want something for nothing, we want people to do it for us. And this skill is powerful. You know, it's bigger than you. Think about it. If you learn this skill, if you got kids, think about teaching your kids right now when they're 17, 18, 20-year-old this skill set. Think about it. You can't teach them with using a trade copy. You don't have the skill. You're not thinking long term. Right? Let me get off that. Y'all getting me hot up in here. All right. Any other questions before I get in there? But just to let you guys know, we have been having a great year. We definitely had a great 2 or 3 months with the signals, even the free group. And just to let you guys know, we do the free group. We have other things with our other platform. But, you know, a lot of people out there is all talk. So the reason we have the free group, and no, you're not going to get all the calls and signals that I do for the paid members, but we want to show you guys that we know what we're doing. If you don't have to join us. You just look at the free, get the free signals. Get on a couple calls. If that's all you need, fine. You know, we're looking for, if people want to go to the next level, then we on the other side. I'm just being straight up. It doesn't matter to me. You know, we want to help the people want to go to another level. If you don't, you just stay in your lane, make some money off the signals that I drop in, and everything's lovely. That's where it is, guys. All right. So, but we did the free chat like 2 weeks. I think I went 9-1 in there the last 2 weeks, guys. Been killing the market. And to this, in our pay group signals, I went, this is what I did this week, 7-1, 450 pips this week in our pay group with the education platform that I'm part of. But we trade, man. We get it in. But Euro Swiss franc with the first trade. Anybody have any questions on the trades, what I'm breaking them down, feel free. But before I start, getting back to the weekend, the end cap, the weekly recap. Guys, if you don't take anything from this, always at the end of every week, you need to know what you did. You need to look back and know how many trades did I take, how many wins, how many losses, how much did I make per day, how much did I make per trade, if you want to get deep in it, to really understand where you are as a trader. That's really where the name of the game. And it's question amazing.
Question in the chat.
Oh my God. Who's writing all this? Sorry, 3 here. So can't speak. Blue in action. Was the signals posted in the Discord?
He's not sure. Should he take TP1 or let it ride to the last one? You just
that's something you that's where you have to go. And I and let me say this. All right. I'm gonna just break down. That's something where you have to learn. You got to put a little bit more time in with doing your research on understanding trading. I mean, I can give you a signal, but you need to put more time in and how to understand how to trade. I can't teach you how to trade, you know, just, you know what I mean? You gotta put some time in. And obviously, if you're trying, and I'm gonna be straight up, if you don't know how to take TP, if you don't know how to take a signal, you probably don't need to be trading live or anything anyway. I'm just being honest. You need to understand a little bit more about trading before you even start taking signals. Anybody that's up here taking live signals and don't understand how to, like, what this, you know, you guys, and let me, man, my internet slowing down. Hold on. All right. If I put this in right here, and I'm gonna just show you what it is. All right, this is my long position. Man, my internet. Can you guys hear me? This is my.
Yeah, you going in and out, in and out.
Oh my God.
You're going in and out.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Hold up. Give me one sec.
All right. Okay, Mr. Boy. The signals are like he's showing right now. We're not gonna put in sale USD JPY at 130. Like that's we don't do it that way. We show you the chart.
Hey, Kurt, can you hear?
I can hear you. I can hear you. You go say something. Yeah. No. You're going out again.
All right, you hear me now?
Yeah, I hear you.
I don't know, man. Hold on, a couple minutes, guys. Yeah. But go ahead and explain that to him, Kurt.
The way he has on the chart right here, like this is EJ. We send a picture out just like this. He sends it out in the group. All right. Red is your stop loss. Green is your take profit. Buy going up, that's a buy. Your gray line in the middle with the red, 134.468, that's your entry. 134.498, that's your entry. 135.150, oh, it's raining hard. 135.150, that's TP1. And then at the top, of course, the 136.747, that is where he expects it should go based looking to the left at the next resistance zone. You know, so this is how we send them out. We don't just send out. If we send out just sell USD JPY, you don't see the chart. You don't know what you're looking at. You're just putting in numbers. We're trying to show you how to read the charts. So we want you to, like you said before, we want you to learn this stuff, not we just give it to you and you do it because at any given day, we can stop giving it to you. But if we show you how to do it on the charts itself, and you look, you start to look at why he took a sale there, I mean a buy there, you start to look at why. You know, yeah. You start to understand it. So this is why we do it this way.
Can you hear me now, Kirk?
Yes, sir.
All right, sorry about that. Yeah, but basically that's why I've had several people ask me, why don't I do it that way? That's the easy way. I mean, that's what I'm going back to. Everybody want everything handed to them. That ain't what I'm doing. I do it this way because this is giving you a picture of how I'm entering the trade, you know, and hopefully making you wonder and give you a better view of what's going on behind the scenes.
Right.
But that's what I'm saying. Everybody just wants you to just give you numbers and plug in. No, learn the trade.
And Mr. Boyd, the picture is sent. He said, thanks for the explanation, but can the picture be sent? We do send the picture.
Yeah, the picture be sent. And if he's in the free chat, that's all I did. I send the picture just like this.
Yep.
So this is the reason why, but this is the trade. The bottom red number is the stop loss. The gray number is my entry. I may adjust this, and just to let you guys know, sometimes I have it at 15 pips, sometimes I have 20 pips. The first take profits is only for me to count it as a win because for the group. If it doesn't hit the take profit one and reverse, then it's not a win for the signal group. So it has to hit take profit one. And that's the only reason why I have take profit one. And basically what we're saying is, the way we count it is like here, Euro Swiss franc, right here. And what we're saying here, hold up, let me go to 15 minutes, sorry. So like right here on the Euro Swiss franc for the first trade of the week, basically what we're saying, price went here, right here, went all the way up here. What we're saying is from here, there to there is 92 pips, 93 pips. We don't know. We got different levels of traders. The first, one trader may say, you know what? They traded a higher lot size and they took 15 pips and ran. Somebody else may have a 40 pip take profit. You know what I'm saying? Somebody may be, I know Chris Dobbs, he does a lot of swing trades. He might have got all of that. So I will count the entire move, but what we're saying is so from here to there, you should have made money. That's all. We don't count because it's blue or it goes blue. You know, you heard the term, it's on you, and we, you know, we count as a win. It has to at least hit take profit one for me to count it as a win, a signal as a win, and whatnot. Does that make sense? I want to make sure everybody understand how the signals work. Put a one in the chat if you understand what I just said. Or don't say anything at all. All right. But thanks for it. All right, good. All right, so anybody else have any other questions about anything before we get it? All right, the first trade, we had Euro Swiss franc right here with the first trade of the week, guys. And I'm going to break that down. Like I said, we went 7-1 this week in the other group. Five and one in the free. Oh, I forgot. I did three. All right. The reason why I took the first trade again, this right here is on an uptrend. We saw this, and I'm like, okay, we're trying to get into this trade and just go with momentum, guys. And everybody that I'm teaching and understand, I think Rudy and Vince right now, we've been going hard. Those guys see the light. They understand what's going on. And I think it's making, you know, real sense to those guys how this works. Because basically, this is why when you guys, if you've been on any training, everybody always talking about the trend. It's amazing when you get with the trend, it's going to go. And you just got to pick when you want to get in, how to get in, and what you're trying to get out of it. So right here was the uptrend. So I went to the 4-hour. To see more details, and we just, you know, I think we got in down here somewhere, I think in here, but yeah, I just got in somewhere over here to go up for the buy, so that was pretty much an easy trade that you guys see, and I'm gonna just go through. Once you train your eye, you can just see how price just, hold on, how it when it steps, breaking reaches. See it? It's amazing. When you learn that, look at that. It's showing you, it's giving you the play. It's giving you the play. I know I'm pretty good at this, guys. It's giving you the play. Every bottom here is a watt, Vince. Every white dot here could be in a watt.
Every white dot is in support.
It could be a potential buy.
A potential buy.
A potential entry, yes.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Basically, everyone, every time, because all we're doing is waiting for what? Break, come back and retest.
Retest.
Break, come back and retest. So we may not have got the first two, but you could have got one, two, and then this one here, I think we got in and went 20-some pips and got out. But you see how, and this is on all the trending pairs, guys. That's the thing. Don't make it hard. This is all we're looking for. We just looking for these type of trends to take advantage of it. You just got to be patient. But the biggest thing is to train your eye to catch that, you know. And no, it's just going to take time. You can't. And then over here, just look, what's going on now? And I'm on the 1 hour, but we'll go to 4 hour. What's happening now? Price is doing what? Broke the trend line. What is it doing now? Creating what?
Hello.
There you go. So right now, it's creating lower low, lower high. So right here, boom. And Rudy, what's this right here then? This is on the 4 hour. So we know that's strong. What's that, Rudy?
That's the confluence.
For what? You for buying sure. or selling?
It's for selling.
There you go. You see how that stuff works, man? Look, it's right there in our face, guys. Boom. We just going with momentum. That's it. That's the name of the game. So don't be surprised. I'm not saying it's going to happen. This is where a lot of times you guys see this big move, and I know some of you guys that don't really understand how to read a chart. You guys see this right here, and you're like, man, I could have got – why didn't I miss that? Look at that. That's 207 pips, right? So what you think potentially could happen over here? The reverse. It could next week be all the way down here. We're already getting the sign that is reversing. There's no guarantee, but as long as it's getting us lower lows, lower highs, guess what I'm doing next week? I'm going to sell it until it goes the other way. Make sense?
Perfect sense.
Yes.
Anybody have any questions on that? All right. NZDJPY was another nice banger. We killed that right here, guys. NZDJPY, I was mad because I got out early. I should have stayed in. Yeah, I'm mad, Vince. I get mad sometimes. Do as I say, not as I do. That'll be quick. That was a nice first drop. I'm going to be straight up. That was 158 pips. I think I got out like 50 pips. So I should have stayed in, but I didn't get it all. But right here, nice sale. All right, let's go to why I took that trade for the sale. And it's the same thing, guys. The more you stay on these charts, the more you sit. But hold up. All right, daily. Go to the daily, all the momentum. And the reason I'm calling on Vince and Rudy, because I'm working directly with them right now, and they putting the time in, they sending charts, and I want you guys to see what they know. They know their stuff. They don't know it yet, where Vince don't know it yet. Rudy, let me quit playing. But they know their stuff, you know. They know their stuff. That's all I'm saying. So I hope you guys don't mind me bragging on you guys. They know their stuff. They just need to put a little bit, just put more time in on the chart time. That's where it is. The more chart time you put in, the better you're gonna get. So right here, nice downtrend. Just want to let you guys understand too. When prices break trend lines, most likely it's gonna be a price reversal. You know what I mean? So you know, this is why we use structure. Trend lines, support, resistance, and structure. So here we have what? Going down, we just want to get in when we fit in, right? So I think I think it was right here. I think I was looking at something like this, and it came back up to here. I have to go back to the original. Yeah, I think it was right here. I have to look at my entry. But yeah, so basically you guys see it just broke. And you see, again, guys, you see, yeah, it was up here. All right, yeah, I remember this now. And you guys see how even on the higher time frame, that's a stronger, what? What's this support? Turn into what? Ease. Ain't y'all getting tired of me showing y'all the same thing?
Nope.
But I'm just trying to tell you guys, and I know this is going to happen to Vince and Rudy. When you start seeing that, you're going to be rubbing your hands together. You know why? Because you about to get paid. That's what I do. When I see trends like this, and I can mark it up like that, I'm about to get paid. Makes sense? So we got in here. Let me go to the 15-minute. Where did I get in, man? I missed it. But either way, that was an easy trade. Let me go to the original. Trying to figure out where I got it. Oh, I got it. We got it way at the top, guys. And just imagine now, Chris probably would have held it. I know I wouldn't have held this all, but look at this, guys. I'm not a swing trade. Look at this. This thing went 359 pips.
Oh, wow.
You understand what I'm saying? That's way, and you know, some people may, you know, and that's the thing with you guys. Right now, you really don't know what type of trader you are. You may get to the point that Rudy, you know, you may let stuff swing. You may like, you know what, I'm just let it trail and run and just let it go. Do what it's going to do. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's another thing. You know, I'm not, this is the key. You guys may not trade exactly like me. My goal, and you guys heard me say this time after time, I'm only here to give you the foundation, the core principles of trading. And you know what the core principles of trading is? Market structure and price action. Don't get it twisted. Market structure and price action. And nothing out there can beat it. Hands down. I've been doing this 6 years. Nothing out there can beat it. All right. So that was a nice, thank you. Hey guys, I know you probably think too like this, right? Look, take profit one was 20, but it went 300. Right? Like, man, we could have made a killing on that, you know? So, but that's the potential. That's the one thing too, guys, about if you guys notice a lot of times, and then people are on, you know, on the 15-minute scalping and doing all that. But this is another thing that what's happening when you go to the higher time frame. You're going to get those moves. So what happens is when you catch a uptrend, it's going to move 900 pips. You catch a downtrend, it's going to move. So imagine those moves, just say the average move on a daily, and I don't know the exact numbers, but just say the average move or trend on the daily is 500 pips. All you're trying to do is get in and get what, 50? 30, depends on your lifestyle. Think about that. This is why this is so powerful. Put a 7-minute chat. I don't think you guys hear me. Put a 7-minute chat if you guys understand what I'm talking about, man. I'm ready to go play some golf, man. Y'all ain't feeling it. Put a 7-minute chat if you guys understand what I'm talking about. Thank you, somebody. All right. Let me go another trade. Oh, let me go over one I lost. The only trade I lost was Oddcat, and I think that was on the other here, I think. Yeah, right here. Oddcat, and we went over this the other day on the training, I think Rudy and I. But same thing, I wouldn't have done anything different because if you go to the daily, it's definitely in a downtrend, right? I'm just trying to get in. Go to the 4-hour. I was trying to get in. I'm thinking, okay, it's going to keep dropping. And what I was looking at was this trend line, inner trend line, right here. You know, I'm thinking, okay, it's going to go. But you guys see where it just shot up more to the top, more of up here. And then, of course, continue down. Like it always can stop you out. Maybe. So that was the... second trade that I, the first trade I lost on Oddcat. First trade, is that the first trade? Hold on. No, that was the first trade. We won that. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah, we won that. That was the first trade. But with the second trade, I think we got in over here and it pushed that one off. I might have deleted that. So sorry, guys. I think I deleted that chart and while I was doing some training. All right. Any questions? Anybody have any questions? I'm not going to go through all these trades, man. I'm going to go through the last, which is easy trade, even though it played around last night. Cat, the last trade that we did, her easy trade. And I hope you guys see, and I try to put these dots to show you guys how I'm entering the trade with this rejected, broke, came back, rejected. And if you notice, our price came right there where the zone was, respected it, rejected, and then went up. And this went up about, 64 pips. I didn't hold it all the way there. I think I got out somewhere in here, like 35, and got out. But let me go break down why. Like I said, it's the same game plan, guys, of why I got in this trade. Go to the daily. You guys see it, just a easy uptrend. We'll draw this coast. That's where they're really the trend. And that's really what I saw. And those right there, and this is another thing, guys, when you see the higher highs and higher lows and the lower lows and lower highs on the daily, that's really the easy trades. Because this right here, you don't really see the details on the daily. Usually you wait to the 4 hour. But when you see the details of the rejection, how it went up like this, this is what I'm talking about. Boom, 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 boom. You see that? When you see that on the daily, that's perfect. You know what I mean? So when I came over here last night and I was looking for the last trade, I was like, okay, price was somewhere in here. I was like, oh yeah, that's perfect. Went to the 4 hour, right in here, started looking how to get in. But what happened is, I wish we could have got in here, but what happened was this was at the session change. So by the time, and I don't like getting in right at 6 o'clock, 5:30. So price went up to, I think like right in here, but I couldn't get it. No, it might've been here. Yeah, I couldn't get in to about right here. That's where the recession changed. So once it got in, I knew I had enough room to have a decent stop loss. So I went ahead and took it. And even though we had a nice little, we had probably a 18 pip retracement, then it shot up. But again, let's go to everything's up, guys. Up. And then we talked about this. These are the easy trades. When you're on the daily, everything's up. 4 hour, everything's up. The 1 hour, everything's up. You can't get any better than that. Does this make sense? Anybody have any questions? That's going to be the last one. I think you got to get the gist of everything. But this is mainly for anybody to have questions on the trading for the past week or any other issues that you want me to go over, feel free. I can do that at this time. But I just wanted to kind of go over some of our signals. I hope you guys are taking the signals because I'm hot right now. You better ride me. It's hot right now. So,
are you going to start doing these recaps on a regular, or this was kind of a special treat?
I was talking to Kurt. I may do it like every other Friday. And if we can start getting more participation, I may start doing it every Friday. I mean, a lot of the things that we don't do is because we don't get people to get on it. I mean, honestly, because I'm not going to get up. Like right now, we had about 12, 13 people. I'll get on for 12 or 13. But if we get up here and next Friday we have 3, no. Well, I'm going to take the time out of my day to help somebody and only 3 people up there. This is why I focus on dealing with, you know, you guys one-on-one, because you get the real deal. You ain't got to wait for a group training. Make sense?
Yeah.
This is exactly why we stopped doing the trainings all through the week. Nobody was getting on to take advantage of it.
Yeah. So if we get more people to participate on the trainings and get involved, because the more the merrier, guys. The more people we have, the more fun is good and more, you know. But if we only going to get 3 or 4, I might as well just do one-on-ones with the people that want it. And that's basically what I boiled down to, is doing one-on-ones with the people that want it, and they ain't got to worry about everybody else. And I don't have to schedule time for 3 people to jump on. You know, because think about it. Before we stopped it, let's be honest. It wasn't probably me, Kurt, Rudy, Vince, Leslie, maybe Patrick. Florence get up there every now and then. We bad 3 to 5 people every now and then. So guess what? Cut that out. Schedule. You guys hit me up one-on-ones and let's get down to it, right? Yep. You know, I'm just, I mean, but if the more people get involved and get on the trainings, hey, we'll do more, guys. So just look for it. I may decide. It just depends on what I want to do right now. I may decide to do it next Friday, or I may wait to the following Friday. I may do it next Friday because the Friday after that, I think that's Memorial Weekend. I know I'm not doing anything that, you know. So I may do it next Friday because I probably won't do it after that. What's up, Lamar? That's my main man out of Charlotte. That's it. Anybody else have any other questions? Everybody's good. Did that make Vince? Did that kind of give you a good picture about the journal?
Yeah, actually it did. Like I said, this overcomplicating things as usual.
But that's part of it. Don't get too frustrated. That's trust me. That's if nobody think about it, and I'm just being as honest as I can be. Nobody's really giving you structure when it comes to FOIA, right or wrong.
Right.
So I'm giving you structure. It takes time to learn. I mean, I'm not saying I'm all that because somebody gave me structure. So I'm just saying, if nobody ever told you, hey, you need to write this down, you need to keep up with this, keep up with that, you're not going to get it overnight. So don't get too down, like you should get it, know it like yesterday. That's part of your journey, guys. That's part of your journey. So don't get frustrated. Even though sometimes I may sound like I'm not frustrated, I'm just passionate about it and want you guys to win, man. That's what it's all about for me, because I'm winning. You know what I mean? I can't complain.
Somebody snoring.
Is that somebody sleeping?
Somebody sleep. That's Enron. He's 3. He's in the morning, 3 or 4 or 5 in the morning.
Oh, so yeah, that's the one that says he's up 3 a.m. He don't fall asleep. Where he at over there? He crossed the pond.
Yeah, we heard you, Ron. Don't worry about it.
Hey, it's all right, man. If you're tired, you're tired. Yeah,
at least you made it up here.
Hey, put it like this. That's one thing about Forex. When the market's open, you can make money sleeping. But anybody else have any other questions before we get off?
I'm going to
Eric. Yes.
Hey, man. Watching your webinars whenever I get on, and I understand your trading principle. I'm really enjoying it, kind of reprogramming my brain from losing before and using too many indicators and things. So I've kind of got my head around it pretty good, I think. There's one question I've got with not wanting to, with the risk of making it sounding a bit complicated. I was just wondering, with your personal trading, do you ever take a trade where it's already left from support or resistance and you haven't waited for the trade to come back and actually hit support and resistance, you have enough experience and confidence to see that, oh, the trade's now going to take off, so I'm just going to take it further away from support and resistance and not wait for it to come back and hit?
All right. To answer your question, somebody tell me, what's the limit on my risk as far as pips?
20, 25, 25 pips.
30.
30
is my limit.
Yeah.
So basically, to answer your question, like my trend line, and this is my support, right? So right here, I have confluence for, I'm on the 1 hour, I know. But say this is my entry up here. Now I didn't see it till it got up here. I'm gonna measure. I'm gonna check it. If that's more than 30 pips, I'm not. You know what I'm saying? I don't go. It has to be within my 30 pips. So just like it's funny you say that, because if you look at Cassidy, the last trade we took, if you notice, it was kind of away from my support. But I was able to do a stop loss of 25 pips. So everything is based on my risk. I'll never take anything away from the zone if I got a risk more than 30 pips. Make sense?
I got you. That really clarifies it for me. That's good to have the numbers as well. That's all I really needed. Yeah, man. Because I was just getting.
Goes, Yeah, if it goes outside your wrist, because you got to think about it. And the reason why I do that is you guys got to, everybody knows price. All right, prime example right here. This is a good example right here. I took it away. I took it right here, right? But I knew I could have my 30 pips or less below what? Support. And there was a trend line going across here. That's fine, right? So yeah. I'm not afraid. I know price love to what? What price loves to do, everybody?
Retest, loves to retest.
There you go. Yeah. So I expected a retest, so I'm not afraid. But think about, and this is where, and I used to do this all the time. You know how many people took a buy right here? Even though they lucked up. They lucked up and got it. But think about how many times, and what happens is, and I know this happened to you guys, you take it up here, support is here, price reverse, that is, how many pips? You get stopped out, you go to bed, you wake up, and price is 100 pips in your direction, right or wrong.
I know that story. Been there a few times.
That's why. It's happened to me when I first started. Yeah. So this is why I put a limit on it. I want 30 pips or less, and I have to be, that 30 pips or less has to be at my confluence, support, or trend line. If it's outside of that, and I missed, and Matthew, just to let you know, trust me, I have missed a lot of good trades because I'm sticking to my rules. And I ain't gonna say good trades because they wasn't, and let me change that. They wasn't good trades because they what? Didn't fit my rules for me. But I've seen trades where it may be like 35 pips and I'm like, well, it gotta be 30 a pip and then it shoots up. So be it. I missed it. I prefer to do that and I built my mind around because it really will make me mad if I take a trade outside my trade plan and then it retraces and stop me out, I'll really be mad because I know I shouldn't have did it. Make sense?
Oh, yeah, that does. It's, for me, it's been a psychological thing that, you know, I used to have the fear of missing out.
Yeah.
Rather than having the discipline to wait. And, hey, if you miss out on the trade, if it doesn't quite hit your entry, there's always going to be another trade.
Yeah, there you go. And just to let you know, anybody who said they didn't go through the same thing that you're going through, they're not telling the truth. I had to do the same thing. I used to jump in trades, jump out of trades. I was doing crazy stuff. And then I had to realize I have to have rules. I have to have a trade plan. I have to stick because that's the only way you will be consistent when, and everybody knows, if you guys been following me, go look at all my trades. 99% of my trades are pretty much the same thing. I haven't taken a trade outside of 30 pips. I haven't, think about it. You know, I haven't come up, hey guys, I'm gonna do 50 pips on this. I'm gonna do 60. I don't change. I've gotten to the point where, and I'm gonna be honest, my bank account has made me not change because the more money I make, the more I know it works. So why would I change something that makes me a lot of money? And I'm gonna just say this, and you guys need to follow it when you see it because it works, right or wrong. Seeing is believing. Again, you guys, I don't get into just, you know, blowing smoke and talking. I like to show people what it is. And I hope the signals and the videos and things have shown you this is what it is. This ain't what Eric created. This ain't what he made up. This is the real deal. And I hope you guys can take it and then mold it in your own personality, you know, because what this is the foundation. And you may tweak it and do something to make it fit your personality. I don't know. But I can tell you what, I've been doing this for 6 years, been trading this like this for 5 years. And I have yet to hear, you know, anybody come and show me something different that works better than this. If you do, the door is open, let me know. But I have nobody can do it. Nobody has done it. Can you show us, please, how you traded you similar? Well, I'll go back like 6 months. Hold up, I got a question or a replay. Yeah, I mean, sound like to me, you already know, I mean, you saying, do you know how to do the replay so we can practice? Yeah, you can practice. I mean, are you saying, I'm not understanding. I mean, I think I can show you how it does, but basically what he's asking is how to show people how to use the replay feature And I don't know if it's paid or what, but this is a replay guy. Say for instance, you know, if you're on the 1 hour or 4 hour and you just want to see what you would have done, just practice. You hit this bar replay. And once that comes up, you go back to where you want to start it. So right here, you see this. But when I click this, you don't see it anymore, right? So basically, I'm starting the day right there. And I'm going to just see what the market does and then, you know, enter trades or get out of trades accordingly. And all I got to do is hit play. I hit play. And I very seldom even use that. I mean, that's that tech stuff that, you know, but it's good if you like playing with stuff like that. I don't really get into it, but it's good just to see, let the market move, and then you could have been like, yeah, I would have got in here, or I would have took the buy. So that is a good tool if you guys like that. I have it there. I very seldom use it, honestly. I'm just, like I said, I'm just, I guess you can call me old. I don't know. But yeah, it's there. Anybody else have any other questions? But good job, man. I appreciate you guys getting on. Good questions. I think we got some stuff, some value out tonight, guys. So like I said, I may do it next week just because I know the following week is Memorial Weekend, and I probably won't be out of town. But other than that, guys, I hope you guys have a great week. Rudy, Vince, hopefully you can catch, we can do a Zoom next week, kind of more like the end of the week or whenever you guys need to, just let me know. I'm here.
Thank you, Eric.
No problem. That's what it's about. Yeah, that's what it's about. So anybody else that needed, just hit me up. And let's get this week. Hey, I'm going to tell y'all right now, and I'm going to just say, I said this before, and I don't think you guys realize it until you start. And I know everybody used to have the mindset is they what? They love Fridays. I hate Fridays. The market is closed for me on regular. Crypto, yes.
Say it again.
I'm telling you guys.
Say it again.
I hate Fridays. I'm telling you, man. Fridays, man, I'm going to tell you right now. If they start doing 4x7 days, man. Man, that's all I got to tell you. Man. But I'm sitting here, man. I'm going to tell y'all, I'll be sitting around sometimes just like, can't wait to Sunday afternoon, like Sunday evening. I'm like, man. Like, I'm telling you, that's how bad it is, man. I love, man, I'm telling you, when you have something where you can make money at home in your shorts and t-shirt and drink and do whatever you want to drink and, you know, whatever, and they ain't got to leave the house. I mean, you can't get any better than that, man. So, man, but I'm going to tell y'all, I hate Friday. I know a lot of you guys out there full-time jobs. I know it's your break, but I'm gonna tell you, I don't like Fridays. I love Sundays. But that's it, guys. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Get on the chart, study, and hopefully we have another good trading week, man. We had a good year so far. And hopefully I can help you guys to have a better rest of the year. All right, Kirk, you have anything?
I'm good, man. That's good. Good training tonight.
All right, no problem. You guys have a good one. Talk to you guys later.
All right. Take care.